Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So I'm gonna show you some brushes that I feel that are worth it for only 10 bucks. I don't know if this has been floating around on YouTube yet, but I haven't seen any videos on it, but I'm gonna make this video because I feel like it's worth it, especially for those who are looking for brushes that are affordable, like budget friendly, and not only that, like it works. So these are the brushes, and these are the AOA Studio Fox Mink brush set, and it comes with a free leather roll, but this is vegan, so it does state that in the website that it's vegan. Where you can pick this up at is on the website shopmissa.com. I have mentioned them a couple of times on my channel, and they're just a really good site if you want to get like jewelry, makeup, any accessories that are like common, like socks or like scarves and stuff like that. I got my stuff, like my jewelry and my earrings, especially my earrings and necklaces, on there before it became an AOA studio. So I really do like shopping there. I mean, not that I can't afford jewelry like that are, a little bit in the pricey side, but I just think for a dollar, why not? Like they work so well and they look beautiful. I always wear like these small little earrings. Like if you see on my Instagram, the small little earrings, they're from Shop Miss A, and they've been going strong for the past 2 years. So I'm gonna post their website here so I can tell you guys what is the description of it and what does it do. So they say introducing AOA Studio Plush Fox Mink 10 piece brush set, a collection of 10 full size super soft vegan makeup brushes that help you sculpt, blend, and highlight a flawless full face look. The brushes feature matte black wooden handles and black ferrules, which firmly secure the ultra plush velvety bristles for the minimal shedding. This is a full set of 10 AOA Studio brushes, 5 face brushes, and 5 eye brushes. When you purchase a full set, you will receive a new style of AOA black vegan leather brush roll for free. The super soft, flexible black leather vegan brush roll keeps brushes organized and clean, so you can take brushes with you anywhere. Roll, tie, and go. Now, I did notice with this roll when I first got it in the mail and I opened it, it had this really horrific smell. It was like that chemically brand new smell. It's not like that smell when you get a new pair of sneakers. It's not like that. Can't even describe it, but it's like this really bad chemical smell. So what I did was I washed it down with my wipes and I let it air dry for the day. I don't know if you can throw this in a washer. I wouldn't recommend doing that, but it does feel like a very, I mean, it's $10, so I don't want to say cheap, but it's what it is. Like the stitching of it, as you can see, it's not well like made. Like it's not something that you will get from like Sigma, for example, or Wayne Goss. It's not like that, but I've seen better brush roll sets like this. I've had better ones and they still go strong. With this one, it's like, I don't know, I feel like it's gonna break soon. I don't know. Like, it's just the way it's made and the way it's stitched up. Like, it looks like it won't even last through a whole year. I don't really care for this. I care more of the brushes, and we're gonna talk about the brushes. So this is something that I can just throw to the side or give it to my family member. So I'll just do that. What I like that they state here on the website is due to the brush roll being vegan leather, you might experience a scent when first opening the brush roll. And basically they tell you to wash or whatever, which I don't mind that, like doing that. And when I do get brushes for the first time, I do wash them. Now with this, when I washed it, it was like that black dye that was coming out. So it was just a whole lot of it. And I don't think you want to go straight in with using the brushes right away when you purchase it and you get it in the mail, because you do have to wash it. It does have like this really weird scent. So I don't think you want to like put that on your face right away. You want to wash them first. I used them for quite some time. That's why it took me a while for me to post this video. I wanted to try it out off camera and on camera. You probably have seen me use this, especially the video, which I'll link up here. It's with the Viseart palette that I did. It's like a Valentine's Day look. I did use the brushes there for a palette that's really, really high quality. I feel like the brushes did a really good job at blending. And as for like the face brushes, I felt like it was okay. So it comes with five face brushes. The F23 is a really flat kabuki brush, and it does have some type of movement, which I'm not sure how this will work for a foundation. Maybe like a very liquidy foundation, and you want to get like that diffuse airbrush look. I prefer a brush like this one, which is like really, really stiff. Not too stiff, but it's stiff enough to where it's gonna really blend out my foundation well, and it's gonna give me the full coverage that I want. It's not going to take away coverage. Honestly, I don't like this for foundation, but I do like it to press on my powder on after I apply my foundation and everything, like my concealer. I like using that for like all over the face. This is the F22, the plush angled brush. That's what they call it on the website, and it says it's great for contouring and precision blending. Now, I do agree with that and give me like that really nice chisel look. I like it for that, and sometimes I like using this for blush too if I just want to really have like a nice subtle blush. I don't use this for blushes that are really pigmented or very, very like potent, because when you do use like a brush like this that's not big enough or like big enough to diffuse and blend out that blush, it's gonna look really harsh. This one, the F21, is the plush face brush, and on the website it says a large fluffy brush perfect for dusting off all types of face powders. So I agree with that, and I do like it for that. I really like it. It does get in there for me on my face to really like dust off any powder after like applying translucent and whatnot. I love it for that, and I love it to like also carve out my contour, like to clean up underneath, like a reverse contour. So I like it for that too. So this is a really good brush. I really like it. I've been using it a lot. This one is the F25 brush, and this is the plush highlighting brush. Applies and blends out cream or powder highlight for subtle or blinding shine. And I do agree with that, and I do use it for highlight. I love using this for highlight, and it reminds me of this brush right here, but this one's more bulkier and fatter than this one. But this is like perfect. I love using this for highlight as well. And it is a little flimsy. Like, I don't feel like it will blend out your cream highlight, in my opinion, because of the type of brush it is and how flimsy it is. And I feel like it's gonna move and be streaky on the face. So I only use this for powder. And I also like using this to like dust underneath. Like, if the big brush can't do it, then I'll use this. The last one is the F24 brush. This is the plush blush brush. It says go-to brush for a flawless application of cream or powder blush. Now, for this type of brush, like I said, I don't think, it will be great for cream. I never used it for cream, but I don't feel like it will really blend out really well. I think it will give like a streaky finish, and I do like it for a contour. Like, same thing with the other brush. And it's funny because I reverse these. I use this for blush and I use this for contour. Moving on to the eye brushes, and there's five of them. This one is the E137 brush. This is a shader brush, what they display in the website. And it is a shader brush, like from what it looks like. And then on the side, it's pretty flat. So this would be good on packing on shadow, especially matte shades. I love using this to pack on like on the outer eye, like a black shadow or like a really deep color shadow, and just kind of blending it out. And also, like the way it is on the top, it feels like a little fluffy, so I can easily just blend out that color. And this one is the E135 brush. This is called the eye blending brush. Easily blends out eyeshadows and concealer. Now, like I said a million times, the fact that this brush is so like flimsy and it just moves easily when you blend out, I don't think this will be great to blend out any creams. So I'm just gonna say that for the rest of the video, I don't think these are really great to blend out any creams, because of how the movement is. Like you see, it's like compared to this brush, which I'll show you here, it stays put right here, which is stiff, and then everything else on the top does move. But with this type of brush, it's like the whole thing moves. So I don't think it's good to blend out any creams. But I do like using this to use as like to blend out my transition shade or to blend out any harsh lines. So that's what I like it for. This one is the E136 brush, and it's considered a tapered brush on their website. A tapered blending brush, excuse me. Great for diffusing the crease and blending shadows. And I do like it for that reason, for that purpose. It does blend out my crease area very well. I really like it, and it's like a smaller blending brush compared to this one right here. So I do like it for that, and I think it's like a really good brush. This one, the E139, is called a smudge brush on their website, and it's like this really, really small brush, and on the side it's flat. And I do like using this to pack on shimmer shadows, or like to just blend out that small area in my crease, like that little shadow, just blending it out really nicely. I think this brush is really good for a multi-purpose, kind of brush. And like, I like using this for the inner eye or the brow bone. So this is a really good brush. This last one is the E138 Detail Shader Brush, and is accurate blending of any small or detailed shadow placement. And honestly, I like using this for the brow bone. I don't really use this for the crease or anything like that. I haven't used it on the outer eye, like in my experience, I don't remember, but I do like using this for the brow bone. Anything that's like an angled brush, like this small, I like using this for the brow bone to pack on that highlight on the brow bone. What I think of the brushes, I really do like them, and I totally recommend them, especially for people who are starting off with makeup. Excuse me, I have to burp. I think that this is totally something that a beginner could use and start off with, especially for $10. I think it's totally worth it. If you're just a really big fan of the website itself or the brand, or you just like brushes and you love to collect brushes, I think this is something you should pick up. They do have other few brush sets that I'm gonna show you right here. I think it's pretty cool that they're trying to expand and try to show people that you can also get brushes for an affordable price, and it's not a very cheap kind of brush. It's not something that's gonna like easily come off. Like, I've had experiences with e.l.f., like their brushes sometimes will break off very easily. Like the ferrule and the handle would just come off, and it's always like that with e.l.f. I'm not bashing e.l.f. I really like their brushes. I just wish that they did a better job with gluing down their brush handle and everything. But with this one, I don't feel that way. Like, I don't feel like it's gonna break off. And the way it's like really, like it's compacted, like it's really, really good and sturdy. So it's not like flimsy and cheap. But with this brush set, I think it's great, especially if you are not sure on how to use brushes, or you never really own a brush set. I think this is really good and a really great set for you to start off with. Now, would I continue using this? Of course, I would continue using them. I don't think I'll use all of them because, like I said, I've tried them out and I don't think some of them will work out for me, in my opinion. Like, I have a million gazillion brushes that will do a better job than some of the brushes that I've had misses with. My favorite brushes would have to be the E135 and the F25 brush, the highlighting and the blending brush. I think like these are like the best ones out of their whole entire brush set, and I'm gonna continue using these, so you're gonna see them in my videos, in my future videos. And yeah, it's $10. Like, how can you beat that? Like, I think that's a great freaking deal. I've seen brushes that are, expensive, and brushes that, they claim that it's great, but next thing you know, like the whole entire brushes just falls apart. And that's all I have to say about the brushes. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. If you're considering in buying these, let me know in the comments down below, and I'll link right directly to where you can purchase these. And they have other ones, so check them out, check out the rest of their stuff. And also, like the video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, and subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe, of course. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.